Okay, the Lewis structure for N2O5 is a bit challenging. If you had time, you could work to fill the octets and find a combination where they all were satisfied, and you could look at the formal charges and make sure they were as close to zero as possible. But let me start you out with the skeleton structure, and we'll work from there just to save some time. So that's the skeleton structure for N2O5, and we have a total of 40 valence electrons to work with. First, we'll put two between atoms to form chemical bonds. We've used 12 valence electrons, and then we'll go around the outside and fill the atoms until we've satisfied their octets or we've run out of valence electrons. So that's 36 valence electrons. We'll move to the center, 38, and then 40. You can see the octets are fulfilled for all the atoms except the central oxygen, which only has 4 valence electrons. We could take these two valence electrons and share them, do the same over here, and that would give us an octet on this central oxygen, and we'd still only be using 40 valence electrons. The problem is, when we look at our formal charges, they don't seem quite right. First of all, they're not very close to zero. And then when I look at this central oxygen here, oxygen's more electronegative than the nitrogens here. I wouldn't expect to see a positive 2 formal charge on an oxygen. So I don't think this is the best structure for N2O5. Let's go back and see if we can do something different. First, I think I'll move these valence electrons here onto the central oxygen. That'll give it a formal charge of 0. The problem is now my nitrogens only have 6 valence electrons. I can move the valence electrons from the oxygen here to share, create a double bond. That should solve that problem, and that'll also reduce the formal charge on these oxygens here. So now, if I look at my formal charges, they're a lot closer to zero, and the plus one is on the nitrogens. That makes sense because nitrogen's a little bit less electronegative than oxygen, and the oxygens have the negative ones. So this is probably the best we're going to be able to do here. We fulfilled the octets on all of the atoms, and our formal charges are pretty close to zero, and the positive charges are on the least electronegative atoms. That makes sense as well. So this is the Lewis structure for N2O5. This is Dr. B. And thanks for watching.